Marine protected areas are parts of the sea identified as being important for vulnerable marine wildlife or habitats. Once designated, these areas are afforded special protection. Currently, nearly a quarter of English inshore waters are within MPAs, and the fishing industry recognises them as essential for conservation. However, experience has shown that without a strong grounding in scientific advice and careful introduction, some MPAs can cause more harm than good.
We see the point of having marine protected areas to protect biodiversity very important. On the other hand, it's extremely important that they are introduced in a rational way based on evidence.
I'd like to see more dialogue between the fishermen and the people who want to bring them in and see if we can come to some sort of happy medium of where they want them and where we would rather they were put, instead of them just saying, right, they're going there, end of. You know, we should work together, basically. It's pushing the fishermen out of areas they've fished for, you know, generations and generations and generations. And half the argument is, oh, the stuff there needs protected. Well, if fishermen have worked there for so many years and the stuff's still there, you know, what we're protecting it from, we haven't damaged it so far. We might be pushed out of an area we've traditionally worked and go and work on someone else's doorstep. And obviously it means, you know, a little area could get quite a hammering from a number of boats.
It's no good just having a tick box exercise, putting circles or squares on over the seabed. Not least of all because that can lead to a displacement problem. If you displace fishing activity from one area into another, what impact do they have there? What fishing already happens there? What are the knock-on effects? It has to be a system that's managed well, and I think the government's got a good handle on it. I think they are taking the evidence-based approach. I think there are others, particularly some of the more extreme NGOs, that would like to see things move further and faster, and that, of course, is their prerogative.
The MPAs that the Commission and that the government are talking about now, I think potentially could be a big step forward, but the industry needs to have a lot more input about how they're going to be introduced. Certain work that we've done with regards to the offshore MPAs, the people that were implementing it had absolutely no idea about the types of fisheries that were involved in those particular areas.
From our point of view, and I think the government's point of view, if you depart from an evidence-based approach, a rational approach, you lead to big, big problems. We've seen this in Wales, where the government just applied a whole series of no-take zones, which they're now having to revisit. We'd rather get this right first time, and that takes a bit of thought, takes a lot of evidence, takes a lot of work, but it means that we get the result that we need.